The storms are already kicking off for today. Even a lot of strong storms bringing tornado-worn cells all the way across Kentucky. It did strengthen up a little bit. And you also see you have the freezing rain, you have the snow. Everything is going to build up for today. And this is only one of many snowstorms coming through. We still have another one that's going to push through for Saturday, going out on Sunday. Another one that's coming through for Tuesday and Wednesday, potentially. Then another one for Friday that's going to go right across Ohio Valley. But then we're going to go into this big event, everyone. And our polar vortex actually splits now instead of stretches and goes all over the northern side of the lower 48. But when it gets back together, it can't go nowhere because we get sudden stratospheric warming, pushing it further south, keeping it from going north. Now, there is a potential for an upper level high to protect the south and the southeast during this event and keeping that cold air from reaching all the way towards the Gulf. It could eventually push through because it is going to be blocked for quite some time, and it is a powerful cold blast. So make sure you subscribe to the channel, click the bell, and get updates. That way you can follow along with what's going on. Now you can see as you get the storm for today, we still get that one that comes across the West Coast for Friday, coming across for Saturday into Sunday, almost in the same areas. And then we get the one a little further south as we go into Tuesday, as it meets up with the cold air and the precipitation. But look how it also goes up towards northeast, maybe get a low pressure on there. That would help bring more circulation, more precipitation into that snowstorm. And then we get another one forming up for Wednesday going into Thursday as well, in the same locations. Now after this is where it gets crazy, everyone. This is where Euro takes it to where you go way up high and you get this big strong storm bringing a lot of freezing rain, a lot of snow, and you have this big upper level high over here just keeping everything away from the southeast and flowing it into this direction. That's bringing precipitation, but the warm temperatures as well, combating the cold. Now this moves eventually, and GFS sees this further towards the south and allows everything more of a flow towards the east. So there's a lot of change still to come. So the storm coming in for tomorrow for the West Coast, across the Midwest and the Great Lakes for Saturday, out through New England on Sunday. If you are in all of this red, all the way across the country, you have a 50 to 80% chance of exceeding your warning criteria for your snowfall. And your probability of getting at least 6 inches of snow is great. All of this pink across is going all the way up towards 60, almost 70%. And if you're in that purplish color, you're going all the way towards 80 and 90% chance of seeing at least 6 inches of snow on this next snowstorm. Then we have two more coming after that. Those are going right for the Ohio Valley, aiming for the northeast. So remember, I do have this link in the description down below, so you can go click in and see if you're in snow, freezing rain, or heavy rainfall for this next storm system coming through for this coming week. And you see, I am in snow myself. I'm up here in Plymouth getting snow, heavy snow probably. So they're already in pretty close agreement, and you can see with the Euro bringing a lot of heavy snowfall towards northwest, but it is bringing that second storm system right after you get this one coming through for Saturday, going out through the New England for Sunday. That next one that comes in for Wednesday goes a little bit more on a higher trail as it goes out for Wednesday, Thursday with the Euro. You can see with GFS, it's taking a little bit more towards the southern side and taking that one a lot heavier, but both of them is showing it's a lot of freezing rain coming with the transition of these storms that we need to watch for. The only difference is that next snowstorm coming in after Valentine's Day, that big one that the Euro sees bringing a lot of heavy snow on the northern side. The difference with that is that upper level high and the pattern we're going in as we get that sudden stratospheric warming event, everybody. It's shown by the National Blend of Models agreeing that it is going to bring that snow on in. It's going to be heavier towards the central plains and Midwest going across the Great Lakes and for the Mid-Atlantic going towards the northeast for the heaviest amount of snow and chances for the freezing rain. You could get a little bit heavier for northern Arkansas, southern Missouri as you get that transitional as it goes from Wednesday into Thursday on that next storm system, and more for Virginia going out towards Pennsylvania. So the update on the cold air that's coming through, you can see with the Euro and GFS, all the models agreeing still is coming in real deep. It's gotten a little bit deeper with the cold air, but if you look with the Euro taking it right to that southern side where it goes a little bit deeper and colder, and you see with the GFS taking it where it's a little bit on that warmer end. So Euro is seeing a stronger stratospheric warming event where it's keeping that cold air lodged further towards the south, GFS is showing that it's going to be brief and it's going to be able to get away, but it's still going towards the east coast. Euro takes it towards the west coast. So there is a split of difference now. So you can see this here on the update. So as you get that cold air expanded out, remember this is a unhealthy polar vortex. Healthy is just circular. So as it goes into the US, look at this. It actually does get split in half while you get that warming event in between, and it cuts it into two. And this is right around Valentine's Day. This will bring you all that cold air on those snowstorms coming. And this is with the Euro, showing that it tries to come back again. But look at this. It gets a sudden stratospheric warming event, gets lodged further towards the south, and now it keeps everyone in colder air. The only difference is the Euro is seeing an upper level high over here that is keeping the south and the southeast blocked from the cold air, but it does show that it stays there long enough and finally goes through just for a couple of days, showing a little bit warmer than what we've seen last night. Now look at GFS, also agrees that we get that split on both. This is what's going to help bring the cold temperatures down and have some big snowfall totals. And when it goes later, look how you go for that sudden stratospheric warming. It takes it more of a mild event, but still an unhealthy polar vortex, everyone. But it's sitting towards the east coast, where Euro is sitting towards the center and the west coast because of the warming event. So as we go Tuesday into Wednesday, we get a shortwave trough coming through, bringing that snowstorm across Ohio Valley and across the Great Lakes. You can see this upper level high that's starting to really form over here according to the Euro. And that is going to be a saving grace according to the Euro for the south and the southeast, keeping all the colder temperatures away. Then you see this go up on that higher ridge, just being steered by the high pressure. But that cold air coming in would be blocked. Eventually, after the 17th or 18th, have a good chance to finally punch down. And it's going to punch down towards the southeast, not towards the south central. The difference is the GFS takes that upper level high and elongates it more into the Gulf. You see that? And it gives it a chance to stay more on that easterly flow. So that's the difference between the Euro and the GFS, what's going on with that upper level high in the Gulf and the Caribbean. So as it comes down right before Valentine's Day, this is that cold air punching down. This is your temperature anomaly, well below average temperatures punching down, above average on the eastern side. And look how it brings up that above average anomaly while we get that cold air on the northwest, and the upper level high helps bring warmer temperatures further north into the lower 48 and protects it for a few days, but eventually pushes through anyway because it's getting blocked and is staying further south in that pattern. GFS takes that upper level high further south, where it's not really bringing the warm temperatures all the way north into lower 48, more like across the southeast and a little bit more of the mid-Atlantic, while that cold air punches down for Valentine's Day, and we have multiple rounds still, according to the GFS, well into the 20th. Going all the way down towards Mexico with a big below average anomaly, everybody, because of that block. And I will see this afternoon for an update, so make sure you click the bell to get the latest updates. Now showing the snowfall coming with this next system as it comes across for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So here's what you're looking at. All the yellow, you're looking almost a foot. This is all 8 inches or above. Really up to 12 inches and above. It all depends where you click at. See, the yellow is a foot. But all this red and this orange goes 5-6 inches. And this goes all across. Northern Idaho is going to be lower, but it's going to be heavier across southern Idaho. Right around Boise, might get a few inches as well. Look how it goes across Montana, bringing you some good heavy snowfall ratings. A lot of people getting 5 and 6 inches on this next storm. Still showing it's going to be southern North Dakota, central and northern on South Dakota. Through Minneapolis, you look like you're going to get 6 or 7 inches. A little north in Duluth is just going to be a couple. But as you go further towards the south, like northern Iowa, you could get a couple as well. Going through to UP, Wisconsin, you see a lot of people just getting 5 and 6 inches. All the way down, potentially towards Milwaukee, where you're getting 2 or 3 inches as well. The UP is going to get a little bit on the western side, heavy on the eastern side. And Michigan getting a lot of good snow. 5 and 6 inches, maybe 3 or 4 for Detroit. Further south towards Michigan is a little bit warmer. 2 for Kalamazoo. Then as we go across Pennsylvania, showing us going to be northern in Pennsylvania this time on that snowstorm. Northern New Jersey, maybe Long Island getting in on a couple inches, but very heavy for New England. Anywhere from upstate New York, Vermont, New Hampshire, Maine, Connecticut, Massachusetts, Rhode Island. Everybody getting in on a lot of good snowfall on this next system coming. But be careful of this storm system, everyone. Please, if you do not have to be on the roads, let that go by. Do not be on the roads because this ice is going to start building up. And then the snow is going to start going towards the northeast. You're going to get a little glaze of ice after that as well. But watch out for these storms. These storms are some pretty strong storms. So remember, everyone, check on your neighbors. Check on their pets as well. Make sure everyone is okay. Make sure you be that good neighbor. Before I go, 1 Corinthians 13:4-7. Charity suffereth long and is kind. Charity envieth not. Charity vaunteth not itself, is not puffed up. Doeth not behave itself unseemly. Seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked. Thinketh no evil. Rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. Amen. Have a great day, everyone. Be safe. I will update you this afternoon what is going on with this polar vortex. Is it going to get blocked? Is it going to last longer? And which side of the country is this going on? Thank you so much for your time. I appreciate every single one of y'all, and thank you for all the support. I really appreciate that. Remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Make sure you check on your neighbors.